Come on in. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for the invite.
Make yourselves at home.
Thank you. Happy to be here, Shepard.
Man, this music is hot. The right music sets the tone for the whole party, right, Esteban?
Sure. My parties are always a little hit and miss, to be honest.
Stick with me, bud. I'm a party legend. Back in school, they called me Party Vega.
Golly, I hope they had t-shirts printed.
I ran with a simple crowd.
I can't get over the size of this apartment. The electric bill alone could have paid for my college tuition. Or funded the war.
Or made a nice down payment on one of those Atlas mechs. Always one in one.
Or put an air conditioner in this suit. You have no idea how hot it gets.
But you have no plans after Edie? Someone more human?
No. She's smart, she's funny, and she's into spaceships.
You know what you want. I can respect that.
So, Ashley, you much of a partier in your younger days?
Younger days?
No, I mean, not that you're... Crap.
Relax. I'm just razzing you, Cortez. You know, back in school, I was too busy looking out for my sisters, so no. Not much of a partier.
That's too bad, Williams. Stick with me. I'll make sure you have a good time.
Oh, yeah? You got plans for me, Vega?
Me? Nah. Nah. But why not come sit a little closer?
Hey, you're a beautiful...
Hey, Shepard. You gonna have a drink?
Sure. How's everyone doing?
Ask me after 5 more of these. I'll drink to that.
Am I gonna find you on the floor tomorrow morning, LT?
Here's hoping.
Well, that's great. I can wake you up with my abuela's huevos rancheros.
Hey, thanks for doing this. I kind of needed to unwind a bit, even just for a night.
I think we've all learned to rest.
That we have, Steve.
Here's to us. And a chance to rest.
I saw one on Ilium.
Trainer, do people ever have a hard time understanding your accent?
I wish they did. Something about an English accent says, I'm available, please hit on me, even when I'm not on Earth. If I had a credit for every amorous attempt I've had to reject over the centuries, I could purchase the Citadel. When I was an archaeology student, I found galactic dialects to be fascinating. All of the phonetic variants.
Liara, this is a party. The only dialect I want to hear from you is inebriated Asari.
So, do you have infiltration software that lets you fake being drunk?
Yes, though it is rudimentary. The planned strategy was to avoid social situations where naturalism would come under scrutiny.
I want to see it.
You are seeing it now.
Man, some Cerberus programmer phoned that one in.
Wow, this is quite the apartment.
Seriously, you see that waterfall? And that hot tub looks like something I might want to check out later. Without you.
And this was Admiral Anderson's place?
I could never live in a place like this. I'd worry about breaking the furniture.
Hi. I'm trying to socialize. I'm not particularly good at it.
Not much for big parties?
Well, if I know people, sure. But some of your friends are legends. I can't just ask if they've tried the hummus. Also, Dr. Chuckwas apologizes for not being here. It's some emergency medical consult on the Citadel. She sent some fancy liquor, though. It was great. Wish you could have had some.
So, Shepard, you can serve this will, but can you drink it?
Someone has to drive you all home.
Are we sure the Normandy is still there? Has anyone else tried to steal it?
Stealing the Normandy? Now there's an idea.
Wait. What? Who?
Trainer, you still have your toothbrush?
We can always get another Normandy. Ask them to please build us the SR3.
But wouldn't that require you to change your name? Tali Zora von Normandy SR3.
It's Vas Normandy. Von means one who has a weak bladder. Which feels appropriate right about now.
We've seen a lot of good times on the old girl.
That we have. Indeed.
Hear, hear.
Some of you more than others. I'm just honored to have squeaked in.
To the Normandy.
And to falling in love with the ship's captain.
Protean gatherings were nothing like this. We considered the future and respected the dead.
Yeah. Get a bunch of Krogan together and things always get fun. And probably broken.
Even long ago, your kind was never known for its intelligence. I mean restraint.
These things are better when you have redundant systems and natural plate armor.
Okay, I admit. When I first heard about it, I thought Archangel was some sort of mascot for a perfume company.
I'm glad I got your hopes up, Tally. When I first heard about it, I thought the Shadow Broker was a shadow boxer. I pictured some sort of Elcor punching bag.
And that's exactly what the galaxy should keep thinking. Not that I have a personal interest in it or anything.
Edie, up for some bad examples of human behavior?
I think you mean examples of bad human behavior.
Just a hint. Grammar correction? Not the best icebreaker.
You know, I miss the days when Cerberus was just hilariously incompetent. You know, back when Miranda here was in charge.
The only thing I was in charge of was the Lazarus Project, which, you will note, was very successful.
Hey, Commander, this is Cerberus. We were studying some Rachni, and they got loose and killed all our guys. Can you take care of that?
They did rack up quite a body count. At least back then, it was usually their own bodies.
But we did bring Commander Shepard back.
And after taking down the Collectors, I cut ties with Cerberus, got loose, and started killing all their guys.
For which we thank you.
Jeff, do you remember that I am also a Cerberus project?
Oh, crap.
I must admit, I still feel like something of an outsider. You all have such a history with Shepard.
It's mostly a lot of running and shooting, and usually somewhere in there a button needs pushing, but Shepard always hogs that part.
Yes, a history of close calls, narrow escapes, and more near-death encounters than I care to remember.
Working with Shepard reminded me of my younger days, running with mercenaries, blowing things up with mercenaries, and occasionally sleeping with mercenaries.
I remember first meeting Shepard. All I kept thinking was, I hope he took a shower, because my filter needs replacing, and humans carry a lot of germs.
Years later, here you are, drinking his alcohol through a straw. I'd call that progress.
Something to look forward to, then.
So, Liara, is this the Tassoni Shepard love nest? I hope we aren't interrupting anything you two might have been planning.
Whatever the species, males never change, do they?
Perhaps it's a good thing we Asari don't have any.
Ha! Not my problem.
The Krogan are very strong. I believe it would take more than 100 Pyjaks to defeat one.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Didn't think I'd see you here.
So who is strongest, you or the tank braid?
What'd I miss?
The Prothean here wants to know who would win in a fight between me and Rex.
That's a good question.
No, it isn't. Baby Pyjak here wouldn't stand a chance. Don't listen to this fossil. The only thing he could defeat is a glass of warm milk. Ha! I got head lice bigger than you, Junior.
This talk does not prove anything.
Only one way to settle this. Now the party's starting.
Another time, guys. I don't have time to buy new furniture.
Ah, just when it was getting good. Yeah, you got lucky.
This is nice. I don't spend much time with everyone like this. As friends. Of course, if you wanted to steal me away later, I wouldn't say no.
Protheans can read the smallest details of our environment. That dude, human. I would like to touch you.
I'm not nearly drunk enough for that.
You then, shuttle pilot. How about you?
Why is Javik getting all touchy-feely?
Hey, collector-looking asshole. Maybe go touch yourself.
That does not happen until the end of the party.
Shoo. Shoo. Of course, the SR2 is much bigger, so they upgraded the ventilation system. More of the...
The Cerberus upgrades were a vast improvement.
There is a lot more space now.
But if you move further up, it's more of a...
A what?
You have to imagine my arms are the wings.
Of course. Over by the med bay.
Exactly!
Drink! I'm drinking! But it's not a drinking game. Afraid to lose? Nothing to do with fear. I know I'll lose. Logic is for Solarians. The great Erdnot Rex is back down from the challenge. I never accepted the damn... Fine! Drink! Ha! Fair warning, Grunt. My first liver dried up years ago on account of this stuff. I'm sure both of yours are still pink and squeaky like baby Pijacks. Quit stalling, old man. Drink!
Edie, what can I get you? Anything? Let me get you something.
That is not necessary, Steve.
I can't tell if you're having a good time.
I am observing displays of complex social entropy. So yes, I am having a good time.
I mean, the original Normandy was a big deal. You were there, Doc. What was it like?
It was overwhelming at first, but it became a home.
I hear you, man. I wish I could have seen it.
Well, you got to see the Superior model.
Hate giving Cerberus credit for anything, but I gotta say the SR2 beats the SR1. Hands down, from what I can tell.
What are you guys talking about?
Tally was acting out the differences between the original Normandy and the SR2.
Acting?
I may have recorded it. And that recording may already have 6 million extranet hits and a fan site.
You better hope I never find you.
Yeah, but which one's better?
The SR2 is harder to perform. Does that make it better or worse?
The SR1 was a decent ship, but the SR2 gave the Normandy a fresh start. It made it something truly great.
The original Normandy was developed by the Turian Council and the Alliance. It's a symbol of cooperation between members of the galactic community. And we wouldn't be where we are now without it.
The SR2 has been through a lot, and it'll see us through a lot more.
I wouldn't change my name for just any ship.
I thought the Admiralty Board changed your name.
Yes, but in hindsight, I might have considered it.
How about that one? On the arm there? Got that taking some knives off a gang of drunk Batarians. They figured they could stop me from collecting the bounty on their boss. Idiots. So, this one's from two Krogan that had a problem with me running Arlak Company. They learned to live with it. Turns out only one of them had to. Ha ha ha! You're all right, Grunt. Shepard.
Grunt?
Shepard!
Rex?
Commander Shepard. Shepard, Shepard, Shepard.
Rex? Grunt?
Shepard! Shepard! Shepard?
Commander!
Javik?
Apologies. I have been... drinking the provided drinks.
Sure. You might want to tap the brakes a little. Everyone having a good time?
Will there be food available soon?
You're hungry, Edie?
No. However, my research suggests that serving intoxicants without nourishment is considered unwise.
I can eat.
In my cycle, we had food. Many of varieties.
You feeling okay?
I am Prothea. I never feel okay. Though this drink is changing that.
Know what I could go for? Fish and chips. Greasy, salty, crispy, flaky, melt in your mouth.
Yes, that. Let's get that.
Shall I arrange some fish and chips, Shepard?
Steve, is that your favorite?
Actually, I'm a dessert guy. My aunt used to make this chocolate lava bomb cake.
When I first escaped from Cerberus, I found these chocolate chip cookies at a store. Ripped through the whole damn thing.
Nothing in this cycle compares to the food of my people.
Maybe you should get cooking then, Javik.
Most of our ingredients are extinct. Except Krogan. Sarin, Durian, Varian, and Corey. Is there any we could spare?
Hope you don't feel left out, Edie.
Do not worry. I've been employing a socialization protocol feature that came with this unit. It is called Smile and Nod.
Okay, I'll see about arranging more food then.
So, talking about food at a party, like, for fun.
Bored?
Is there a place I can go light something on fire?
The fireplace is right there.
Eh, it's not the same.
Do you miss the Normandy? I'm not sentimental, but sometimes I do. A lot has changed.
Some things have changed, but there are still familiar faces. Me, Shepard, Joker, Edie.
The last time I was on the Normandy, Edie didn't have a face.
Okay, that part's different.
I knew nothing could beat the SR2, at least for now.
For now?
Well, yeah. Let's say one day I get my own ship. That ship will kick some serious ass.
I suppose it will.
Sightlines aren't bad. A blind spot there. Could set up here, but if they enter through that way... too exposed if I block off that window. Now there's an idea.
Garrus? What are you doing?
Just checking the place out, Shepard. Can't be too careful. Don't get me wrong, this is a nice apartment.
But?
Well, for starters, too many windows. And they're too big. Makes it easy for someone to track your movements.
Why don't you relax and enjoy the party? The apartment's fine.
Fine? You just had your clone try to kill you. Suppose tomorrow, Liara's evil clone comes after you. Or Joker.
All right. Have fun.
I could probably set up a sniper post there. Good overall view. Nice clear shot at the entrance. And if I dismantled that table, it would make good cover. Shepard, you moved the Normandy's main battery into here, and I think I'm home.
So, Edie said you found her voice attractive. Well, actually, she said the word you used was like, or something.
That was when I thought she was a VI. Anyway, you'd just better treat her right, Moreau.
Oh, somebody jealous? I think you had a better shot when she looked like a holographic chess piece, trainer.
I wouldn't have said chess piece, precisely. But listen, the point is, you hate AIs. You had to overcome all your hang-ups, whereas I was totally fine with AIs to begin with.
Other fish in the sea, trainer.
Not with that voice. It's like feeling smoky satin slide across your skin in soft candlelight. Just...
Exactly.
Wait, are you two arguing over Edie?
No!
Probably not.
Okay, you know she smashed my head against the side of a shuttle?
I know! Twice! I heard it from Liara!
That was like forever ago. Plus, it wasn't Edie back then.
It's really unfair of you to even bring it up.
Yeah, what the hell was I thinking? Probably just brain damage making me touchy.
Apology accepted.
You know, it's not healthy to just bottle these things up.
The hell is up? Still creepy, Kasumi.
Well, I'm glad you two are drunk enough to finally deal with this.
Oh, we weren't planning to deal with it.
We're just happy giving each other shit.
We can call Edie over, and you can discuss your feelings like mature adults.
What?
No.
That would be weird.
Just no.
You don't think she knows? You guys, she's the Normandy AI. She sees every extranet site you browse.
Note to self, delete browser history.
I can show you how to set up an automated task for that.
You guys are great.
When I'm on a mission, there's nobody I'd rather have back on the ship.
And there's nobody we'd rather have getting shot at than you, Ash.
Dodging grenades, getting your face all smashed up by robots. You guys are dicks.
Not enjoying the party, Samara?
Oh yes, Shepard, I am. Although not in the same way as the others, perhaps. Are you worried about me? Don't be. I only stepped away for a moment to use the restroom. And then I found this quiet corner. Reflecting on one's place in the universe while a party rages within reach can feel oddly self-affirming.
Meditating isn't often considered party behavior.
Perhaps. I don't attend many parties, to be honest.
Then I'm flattered.
Your influence in my life causes me to be drawn to you, no doubt. Know that as long as I am able, I will come to you whenever you call. Always.
Thank you. Now get back out there and have some fun.
I will. I promise.
So we're never talking about this again, right?
Absolutely not.
Right. Wait, absolutely not you're agreeing with me, or absolutely not we are talking about this again?
Shut up, Moreau.
Is it done yet?
The recipe calls for more curry.
Are you sure? That seems like a lot.
The recipe is very specific. I have measured the proper volume to the nearest milligram.
Is it done now?
I'm not disagreeing, Edie. I'm just saying that that's a lot of curry.
If we do not follow the recipe, we risk creating something that tastes offensive.
But recipes adapt over time as tastes change or as foods are carried to new cultures. Also, I'm allergic to curry.
Are you gonna be done soon, or do I need to go eat a keeper?
Microfilament, maybe. Say a 5x5 grid across the glass. That might do it.
All right, Garrus, I gotta know. What are you doing?
Nothing. Just admiring the polish on this glass.
It's not clean enough for you?
Oh, it's just... Well, one man's decorative glass wall fixture is another man's explosive glass wall fixture.
Explosive?
Microfilaments, Shepard. Tiny strips of explosives laid across the glass in a grid. It's your first line of defense. When an intruder enters, hit the switch and... Boom! They're shredded to pieces.
Uh-huh.
Trust me, if I had this back on Omega in my Archangel days, there'd be even more dead mercs.
If you say so, just try not to scratch the finish.
You're bluffing.
Don't be so sure. I got a pretty good poker face.
I can tell when someone is hiding something from me.
Right. Anyway, now we put our cards on the table.
It is foolish to reveal secrets to the enemy.
It's part of the game, and we are not enemies. Hey, you want me to deal you in on the next one? I bet you'd be good at this.
No.
See, that right there. Perfect poker face.
What are you talking about?
You're still doing it.
Everybody okay?
The entertainment efficiency of the party was falling due to inadequate food supplies.
Ouch.
Absolutely. Do not be concerned. I am compensating.
I just wanted her to heat something up. Now she's cooking.
With a vengeance.
Edie, I appreciate the help, but parties aren't about efficiency.
A party is a collective event among like-minded individuals. It requires teamwork and an understanding of group dynamics. You did not pass through the Omega-4 relay to assault the Collector base without preparation. Why should this be any different?
Because it's a party. Nobody's gonna die if we do it wrong.
I'm really hungry, Shepard.
But if you were to ask a team member to select the music and you chose Jeff, the results would be disastrous.
I would never choose Jeff for the music.
No, I should do music.
I can help facilitate a positive environment.
And at the very end... I'll hold the line at the snack table.
Agreed. You see, Shepard? A party is a social construct that can be designed for maximum efficiency.
Well, good luck with that. Bring him back alive, Edie.
Commander, can you believe Doc's never played poker?
How are the lessons going?
The Asari still refuses to take risks. Victory does not come without cost.
You're not even playing.
Doc's not much of a gambler.
Be glad we are not participating in one of the games from my cycle. You would all lose horribly.
Aw, be nice to Liara. You're going to have your hands full with me anyway.
Adios. How long have you been there?
Well, my willingness to gamble aside, this has been a wonderful evening, Shepard.
Glad you guys are having fun.
It's nice to see people relax and let their guards down. I'll try not to take advantage.
Time spent being idle? Do you fear the crew will grow soft, Commander?
I think everyone could use the break.
This from the Asari who buries herself in studying Protheans day and night.
Good to know bickering like an old married couple has not changed since your cycle.
Enjoy your game, guys. And I'd keep an eye on Liara if I were you.
Give me a few more rounds and you might not have anything left to wager.
Now this game is getting more interesting.
Tally, are you okay?
Yep. You want to see my tattoo?
I don't think you have a tattoo, Tally.
It's a hologram. Omni-tattoo. Omni-tat. Omni-two. Under the suit. You know, for me. You want to know what it is? You wanna know? It's a pretty bird made of rainbows. It is flying out of the eye hole of a skull, being held in the mouth of a thresher maw with a naked woman holding a sword on its back. Because I'm hardcore, like Izo. Jack suggested it.
Remind me to talk to Jack in the morning. Where'd you get the Omni tattoo anyway?
Down in the lower wards, near the bottom.
I meant where on your body.
So did I. Yeah, I heard that one from Liara.
Get some rest, Tally.
I'll give that. You're a great pilot.
The best, but go on.
All I'm saying is that when it comes to shuttles, I got you beat. I think you said so yourself.
Ooh, shuttles. Only slightly less cool than dropping from the Normandy into Mako. And I bet you couldn't handle the Normandy.
Wait, didn't you get the first one blown up? I
saw one on. This is completely what I needed. Just hanging out. No crazy stuff.
Wonderful party, Shepard. I'm pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, it's nice, isn't it? Glad you came.
Strange to see everyone in one place. Perfect, really.
Okay. So the first Normandy kind of evaporated.
It was unfortunate, but Shepard did get a better ship out of the deal.
I wouldn't fight myself for another ship. Or ever again. No more clones.
Come on, fighting a clone can't be worse than the Collector base. That was some messed up shit.
Yeah, not something I wish to repeat.
I'm glad I wasn't around for that one.
We must never fear the fight against evil. And I had faith that Shepard would see us through.
That ability to triumph despite impossible odds is exactly why Shepard was brought back.
Hey, did I ever tell you about the time I saved the Normandy single-handed?
Yeah, right.
It's true.
Collectors boarded the Normandy. I only had a minute to come up with something to take them down.
So you unshackled an AI. Always a good plan.
I don't hear anyone complaining about Edie now.
Yes, we're all glad she didn't turn out to be an evil robot. Weren't you complaining earlier about how she smashed her face in?
We're losing focus. Edie wasn't a robot back then. And when the Collectors took over, she was still shackled. So it was me, saving the Normandy by myself. Single-handed.
Yes, you did.
Good man.
So, what games did you play in your cycle?
Good question. You don't exactly strike me as Mr. Playful.
There was one game. It has no name in your language. Three teams met in the arena. Their strength, agility, loyalty, all were tested. The winners were honored, while those that lost...
You didn't, sacrifice the losers, did you?
Your cycle allows them to live?
Well...
I will never tire of tricking the primitives. That is a game I enjoy playing.
Aren't you the one who wanted me to bet more?
You're quite determined when you want something, aren't you? You know, Liara, if you're ever looking for a new line of work, I bet we could have all sorts of fun.
What about me?
I usually work with people who are a bit more... subtle.
Hey, I can be subtle.
Are you whistling?
I heard there's a big party in there. Can we come in?
No, you can't. Go away.
How's it going over here?
You can't come in. It's going good.
I see that. Anyone interesting trying to get in?
Not really, no. Get lost. No.
Can I try that?
Sure. Press this button and say no.
No.
Great work.
Oh, good. Thanks.
No. See? Easy.
Keep up the good work.
Will do. I told you already. No!
Worst planet to get shot down over? We're talking pre-war?
Pre-war, life-bearing worlds only.
I'm going with Tarith. Garden world, yes, but it's got those chlorine swamps.
I will see your Tarith and raise you a Zoria. Home of toxic spores and athlete's lung.
Neither of you'd last a day on Tuchanka. And Tuchanka supports life.
I think you meant to say consumes.
That's the point. It's got critters that'll rip your guts out.
Well, assuming it's a crash in a Kodiak, I'll have my arms locker. Bring on the wildlife.
So, you're leading the Grissom Academy students?
Yeah. That a problem?
Just a surprise. Your psych profile suggested you were mainly interested in yourself.
You're telling me I'm only interested in myself? Oh, that's just fucking perfect. Did it occur to you that maybe I'm trying to grow as a goddamn person?
Oh, I could tell you were growing. I assumed it was whatever that is you're wearing.
Oh, these? Well, yeah, they were strapped down with a leather belt before. It's kind of a stupid move to show off your rack in the middle of a maximum security prison ship.
I never had the pleasure.
You'd never survive. You might break a nail.
You have no idea what I'm capable of.
You're a spoiled rich girl cheerleader.
Victim.
Test tube clone princess.
I think it's past your bedtime.
Oh, did I hit a nerve? I didn't get to read your psych profile.
Ladies, I see we've all gotten enough to drink.
Relax, Shepard. I'm not gonna smear the walls with her this time.
And I couldn't possibly think of anything worse to do to her than that haircut.
Hey, cheerleader. You're fun to hate.
You see, Shepard? Best of friends.
Honestly, I thought it might help if you two just kissed and got it over with.
What?
I mean, this is all just sexual tension, right? Two powerful biotics, forceful personalities, confident in their sexuality.
You are shitting me.
Oh my god.
I'm ready to record. I'm pretty sure there's a market for this.
Kasumi, I will find you and I will hurt you badly. Ugh. I need another drink.
One for me too. No ice.
Hey guys, talking shop?
No worries, this is fun for us. So, you don't have a sidearm under your pilot's chair?
The weapons locker is on the bridge, practically right there.
A weapon you can't get to is no weapon at all. When's the last time you trained with a handgun?
Sometime before I got the ass-kicking robot as my co-pilot.
That's no good. I mean, what if you have to save Edie someday?
Unacceptable. You should always train. Pilots are warriors, too.
You know what this is? It's a man emergency. Take this kid out back and make him do target practice.
Exactly. Some range time will fix you up. Right, Commander?
You are not taking me shooting. My testosterone levels are plenty high. I fly a deadly war machine, remember?
Joker, I'm surprised at you. What about the Collector attack? The bridge can get dangerous.
Hey, they totally proved my point. If I'd fired off a shot then, I would have been mobbed. The real weapon is your brain. Take that away, you got nothing.
Still would have been nice to have a little backup at the sushi bar.
You know, there's a combat simulator on the Citadel.
Hell no. Maybe a shooting range if we're not letting this go. Maybe. But not while I'm wasted. Or hungover.
Hungover is the perfect time to train. Makes you angry at every loud noise.
Cortez, you're on. If you're in condition to take me there, you can. But tonight, you gotta match me shot for shot.
All right, Jack. I hate to say it, but Cerberus was wrong about you.
No shit.
You're still violent and maladjusted. But the elusive man never would have predicted you'd bond with the Grissom Academy kids. You are growing, despite everything Cerberus did to you. I find that extremely admirable.
Wow. Thanks. I still really hate you, but you have fantastic tits.
All right. I can live with that.
You're in for a rough time, Moreau. Vega and I are neck and neck when it comes to holding liquor.
Oh, yeah? Here we go. Shot one.
Oh, what the hell is that? Tastes like the north end of a southbound goat.
Bad move, Cortez. He wanted the duel, and he also picked the weapon.
I brought my own batch, bro. 3 parts horse choker and 1 part antiseptic mouthwash.
That's not even a drink.
And yet, here are our second shots. Unless you want to give up?
Nah, this is all over. I'm gonna find a gun and let a few rounds off.
I am sober enough. I will join you.
Have fun. Try not to kill the neighbors. Cortez.
Give me your damn horse choker. Mother of God, you are going nowhere near the shooting range. Just make it stop.
Yeah, I think we're done here.
Shut up and punch me!
What do you think, Samara? Are you enjoying the fun?
Yes. Perhaps not with as much ferocity as other members of the team.
If it gets to be too much, don't just disappear. Promise?
I promise.
Absolutely. Biotics are impressive. I'm not saying they aren't.
You're just saying that they're not that impressive.
I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying. Oh, shit.
No, it's fine. It's not like I'm insulted or anything.
I'm just saying. What I'm trying to say is, I mean, check out these guns. Biotics can't give you this kind of fine instrument. The peak physical form that you see before you.
I'll have you know that my physical conditioning is top rate.
I mean it. Check me out.
Not sure if I can tell just by looking.
Come on in closer. Don't be shy.
Hey, what's going on here? Everyone playing nice?
Of course, Shepard. James was just explaining how physical conditioning trumps biotics.
Really? You going there, James?
Come on, loco. You have to go with me on this one. Biotics are strong, but unpredictable. All that cooling down. A person can improve their physique, but biotics, they are what they are.
He's joking. Right, James? I mean, what's your point exactly?
Okay. Maybe it's not conditioning exactly. Maybe it's just the condition of one James Vega. Come on, Ashley. Check it out. This guy here never has to cool down. In fact, the hotter, the better.
Ugh, goddess.
James, this is a no-brainer. Biotics win, hands down. We're talking about harnessing dark energy here.
Yeah, I hear you.
And Liara is a convincing argument.
Ashley, you couldn't back me up?
Not without closer inspection.
Yeah? I think I can make that happen.
Okay, then. Specialist Trainer, may I ask you a question?
You could ask me anything, Edie.
When you believed me to be a simple VI, you made comments about my voice.
Oh, no.
Should I find somewhere else to be?
No. I wanted to ask you about... weren't you saying something about the Normandy's drive core?
No.
Could you...
I wish to understand why you find my voice sexually attractive.
Oh, that was a while ago. I can't even remember what I said exactly.
She does.
Would you like me to play back my recordings of your statements?
Told you.
Tali, please stop helping.
I'm pissed, but I'm not gonna let it ruin the party. Or should I say, we are not. Right, Williams?
Whoa, leave me out of this, hombre.
More drinks, yes? When you were younger, you ever just throw people around for fun?
People?
You know, people, things, stuff. Pets, cars, whatever.
Of course not.
Did you see that hot tub?
What's wrong, you two?
I am asking Specialist Trainer about why she found my voice sexually attractive.
This is a really good cheese, Shepard. I put some in through the filters. Is it organic?
On one occasion, you said that you wanted to, quote, pin my voice against the wall and run your tongue along its collarbone.
Well, there's a context there that... you were talking about quantum entanglement, and I didn't know you were an AI. There's some kind of herb in the cheese that I can't quite place. Is it sage or basil? Anyway, I was just joking. You know, stress of the retrofits and...
Really? My diagnostic suggested that you were genuinely aroused.
It's really rare to get herbed dextro cheeses. The Turians almost never bother.
You have diagnostics. Cerberus programmed you to check body language.
I get more reliable results measuring pupil dilation and thermal readings of erogenous zones.
Oh, good lord.
Wait, this is dextro cheese, right? Keela, did I forget to scan the cheese? This is why I don't drink.
Fair is fair, Trainer. Edie has a right to ask about what you said.
I was very interested in Trainer's ability to develop sexual feelings for what was, at the time, a bodiless voice.
You are all terrible. Edie, I apologize for saying that I wanted to roll naked with your voice in satin sheets.
Oh, I was not offended. In fact, it was flattering.
Even the part where I wanted to grab your voice by the hair and nibble my way down its back.
I do not, in fact, remember you saying that, Samantha.
Oh, that wasn't out loud. Never mind.
Don't mind me, I'm just going to run a toxin treatment program, so I don't die.
You should bring out those moves more often, Trainer.
You and I dancing at the same time? Too dangerous. We'd light the room on fire.
This is unexpected and fun.
I'm always amazed humans can dance with the way your legs bend.
The way our legs bend.
Yes, you and the Asari. I'm surprised you don't tip over.
I don't tip over until I've found company, dog legs.
Till then, watch and learn.
Hell yeah!
Ha! Go for it!
Captain on deck!
Has he always been like this?
Yep. You have to forgive a few eccentricities.
It's very enthusiastic.
It is impressive.
We should record this and broadcast it for the station. They'll either run away, melt down, or fall in love.
Good to see some things don't change.
Well, I like it, Commander. It's good to see you cut loose now and then.
Thank you all for your loyalty and support.
Oh, hey, Shep.
You're going through my drawers?
I go through everyone's drawers.
Can't you just mingle and have fun like a normal person?
Why would I want to do that? By the way, you have excellent taste in underwear.
Glad you could make it, Kasumi.
Thanks. I'm having a really good time.
By your very strange standards.
Yep.
Jeff.
Yes, Edie?
At social events like this, it is customary to dance with friends or loved ones. Would you dance with me?
It's gonna take a lot more than a polite request to make that happen, Edie.
I have recordings of you talking in your sleep that would make for a highly amusing extranet video.
Okay, that's cheating.
So I won't dance with you, huh?
Hello, Shepard. You will not.
Well, I will.
Seriously, though, don't go there.
Well, then maybe you should dance with her.
Other people are dancing, Jeff.
Yes, they are. And I am sitting here enjoying my drink.
Joker.
No.
Come on.
No.
Seriously?
Ugh, fine.
Could not.
Could you?
You've seen biotics in action.
I could float you off this balcony without breaking a sweat.
Oh, I know you could, but do you have the cojones to actually do it?
James, seriously?
Shepard.
What's up?
Just demonstrating a little biotic supremacy.
You okay, James?
Yeah, this is trippy. I'm kind of buzzing all over.
Do you find it relaxing?
Kinda. Among other things.
Looks good on you.
I'm glad you lost that bet, James. When's my turn?
Careful. I need my full crew back when the night's over.
Okay, you've had your fun. Put me down now.
Come on, let's dance.
Just wait. Look.
Oh, I'm licking. Believe me.
Okay. Look, I think you're beautiful and kick-ass, with an emphasis on the ass.
Thanks, that's sweet. I think you're kind of sweet.
Your lips are amazing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Wow.
Hey, you two. What's up?
Nothing.
Really?
No, Shepard, we're fine.
Lieutenant, did you just giggle?
I did not just giggle. I'm just... You know, I... Shepard, can we help you with anything?
Looks like you guys are having fun. Sorry to interrupt. I should probably go check on Glyph or something.
See you later, Shepard.
Grunt, you okay?
What? Yeah. I got 5 credits.
Excellent. Go back to sleep.
One cold.
Ashley. Lovely. Tú con tantas curvas y yo sin frenos.
What was that? Say that again.
Ashley. Tú con tantas curvas y yo sin frenos.
Hey, everyone. Come over here for a minute. Let's get a photo to remember this. Arrange yourselves on the sofa.
An excellent suggestion, Shepard.
Great idea. I want a copy.
Make way! Make way!
Thanks for coming, everyone. Here's to us. Ready, Glyph?
Of course. If you could all please direct your attention this way.
Okay. Everyone say Normandy.
Normandy!
Hey. Wow, look who's here. How do you feel?
I wish we could spend every morning like this.
Come on. Let's see if anyone else is up.
Is it time to rule the galaxy now? Kneel before Javik. I had a dream. 50,000 years had passed. It was horrible. I was alone. Primitives had evolved. They ruled the galaxy. Solarians, Turians, the Asari. There was one, Liara. She had those eyes and that voice. And she was blue. No, no, it was just a dream. Oh, I smelled primitives. Oh, it was no dream.
Morning, Shepard. So, on the off chance you accidentally trigger an alarm you didn't know you had and you hear a timer start counting down, then remember the code 6492, punch it into the keypad, preferably before the timer goes off. If you don't, well, just hope your insurance on this place covers large and fiery explosions. Did we, break anything last night? I don't suppose you need anything around here. Calibrated. Yeah, okay, maybe I should just stop saying that word, but only if Liara stops saying, "By the goddess." Good thing this place has extra bathrooms. Miranda takes forever to do her hair. You'd think with her genes, she wouldn't need to.
Was someone making tea? I could use some tea. The apartment seems so quiet now.
I am going to die. I didn't know you could go through that many toxin filters in one night. Do I have a tattoo? I remember something about a tattoo.
Morning, Chef. You went all out with the breakfast supplies. I didn't know you could get real milk on the Citadel. I had some. Thought it was soy.
Shepard? Morning. I need a floor to curl up on. Oh, not so loud.
Morning, Shepard. Had a lovely time last night. I see everyone survived the festivities, more or less.
Okay, who wants eggs? Liara, eggs? Trainer. Esteban, eggs? Joker, where is that guy? Ash, come on, I promised you eggs. Rex, buddy, eggs? Tally? Ah, she'll definitely want eggs. Javik, man, you gotta try my eggs. Anyone else? Miranda?
I think I broke my head on something last night.
Hey, you look like shit. You know the best part of an overcharged biotic amp? No hangovers. Even normal biotics get hangovers, but I can drink until I puke and still wake up just peachy.
So, last night, I didn't do anything, did I? I'm checking extranet sites. No hits yet, so maybe I just imagined that last part.
I'm almost sure someone was recording us, though.
Hey, Commander. Hell of a night. So I've managed not to throw up. Feeling pretty good about that. Duty calls, huh?
Yeah.
Even with a hangover? That figures.
Round everyone up, pass out the aspirin, and have them report to the Normandy.
You got it.
I suppose it's back to the fight.
At least we threw one hell of a party. Honestly, I'm tired.
I know. But whatever happens, I know you'll see this through. and I'll be right there with you. We've been through a lot, haven't we? But it's been a good ride.
The best.
Shepard's been through. I'd like to think I come pretty close. And I worry sometimes he forgets. There's a whole bunch of people who lose sleep over him getting back home. Maybe it doesn't need to be said. Maybe we're too dumb to say it. Soldiers like the Commander are rare. Men like Shepard? Even more rare.